Are you looking for a video on solving word problems involving direct proportion? Then this video is right for you. So, without much further ado, let's begin. Hi, my name is Roel G. Carpio, a math teacher and a coach, and I do math tutorial in my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to present solving word problems involving direct proportion using the block model approach. What does a direct proportion mean? Direct proportion is a proportion of two or more variable quantities where the ratio of the quantities is constant. That is, when one variable increases, the other variable also increases. Or when one variable decreases, the other variable also decreases. Examples of direct proportion are the following. Amount of fuel in the tank of a car and distance the car can travel. Second, number of hours and the equivalent number of minutes. Now let us have examples. We have here sample problem 1. A recipe uses 5 cups of flour for every 2 cups of sugar. Anna makes a recipe using 15 cups of flour. How much sugar does she need to use? First is for us to represent the ratio through blocks. Based on the problem, it is said that for every 5 cups of flour, so let us say this box represents 5 cups of flour, there are 2 cups of sugar. So this block also represents 2 cups of sugar. Now, Anna makes a recipe using 15 cups of flour. So for every 5 cups of flour, Anna needs 2 cups of sugar. So all in all, Anna needs 3 times 2 to give us 6 cups of sugar. So in other words, if Anna uses 15 cups of flour, she needs to use 6 cups of sugar to make the ratio equivalent. The other way to do it is to use our general concept that the product of the means is equal to the product of the extremes. So we have here 5 cups of flour is to 2 cups of sugar is equal to 15 cups of flour is to n, since we have to find out the value of n, which represents the number of cups of sugar. So 5 times n is 5n is equal to 2 times 15 is equal to 30, and to find the value of n, we have to divide both sides by 5. So 5 is cancelled, so 1n, or the simply n, is equal to 30 divided by 5 is equal to 6. So meaning to say that Anna needs 6 cups of sugar if she uses 15 cups of flour. Let's have sample problem number 2. There are 250 pupils and teachers who are going on a field trip. If a bus can carry 50 passengers, how many buses do they need to hire? First is for us to represent the given ratio through the use of blocks. It is mentioned in the problem that for every 50 passengers, so let's say this block represents the 50 passengers, they need 1 bus. There are 250 pupils and teachers. So in other words, there are 250 passengers. We need to add 4 more blocks for passengers for a total of 250. Now, for every 50 passengers, they need 1 bus. So they need to hire 5 buses. So, the other way to do it is, again, to use our general concept that the product of the means is equal to the product of the extremes. So, we have here 50 passengers is to one bus, so 250 passengers is to n, since we need to find the number of buses that we need to hire for the 250 passengers. 50 times n is 50n, is equal to 1 times 250 is 250. To find the value of n, we have to divide both sides by 50. So 50 is cancelled. That is equivalent to 1n or just simply n. 250 divided by 50 is 5. So meaning to say that they need to hire 5 buses. Let's have sample problem number 3. A car can travel 10.5 kilometers per liter of gas. How many kilometers does a car can travel with 6 liters of gas? First is for us to represent the ratio through the use of blocks. Based from the problem, it is said that for every liter, so this block represents 1 liter, the car can travel 10.5 kilometers. The car now has 6 liters of gas. So, in other words, to get the total distance that a car can travel with 6 liters of gas, we have to multiply 6 times 10.5 to give us 63 kilometers. So, in other words, the car can travel 63 kilometers with 6 liters of gas. Now, the other way to do it is, again, for us to use our concept that the product of the extremes is equal to the product of the means. So 1 is to 10.5 is equal to 6 is to n. So the n here represents the distance that the car can travel with 6 liters of gas. 1 times n is 1n or just simply n. And 10.5 times 6 is 63. So, meaning to say that the car can travel 63 kilometers with 6 liters of gas. Now, let's proceed to sample problem number 4. A kilo of lanzones cost 40 pesos. How many kilos of lanzones can you buy with your 200 pesos? So, first is for us to represent our ratio through the use of blocks. So, let us say that this block represents a kilo of lanzones. A kilo of lanzones costs 40 pesos. How many kilos of lanzones can we buy if we have 200 pesos? So, we have to identify how many 40s can we get from 200. So, 200 divided by 40 will give us 5. So, meaning to say, we have to draw 4 additional blocks for cost. So, 40. 5 times 40 will give us 200 pesos. We know that for every 40, we have a kilo of lanzones. So, in other words, we can buy 5 kilos of lanzones if we have 200 pesos. If we are using the general idea that the product of the means is equal to the product of the extremes, we have 1 kilo is to 40 pesos is equal to n is to 200 pesos. So 1 times 200 is 200. 40 times n is 40n. So to find the value of n, which represents the total number of kilos of lanzones that we can buy, we have to divide both sides by 40. So 40 is cancelled, that is equivalent to 1n or just simply n. 200 divided by 40 is 5. So meaning to say that we can buy 5 kilos of lanzones with the 200 pesos. So there you have it, how to solve word problems involving direct proportion using the block model approach. I hope that you have learned and enjoyed watching this video. See you again in my next video. Thank you.